The road leading from Lucknow Agra expressway to Mainpuri District Headquarters in Uttar Pradesh has small villages and agricultural fields on either side of the road. A flock of sheep and a troop of goats going to their exercising grounds for foraging as a regular routine is worth watching. In the crisscrossing canals, in which bovine taking a dip in warm flowing water and the children jumping into the pools of water, testing their swimming skills, can be witnessed. A pair of sarus have tied a lifetime bond and started living in a territory by foraging together and announcing with their trumpeting calls to other flock members about their territory, using a large repertoire of calls and displays. When the breeding season has come, which is during the monsoon, have selected a shallow wetland nearby. The wetland is suitable as darters, herons and bronze-winged jacanas are already inhabited in that area. The wetland is adjoining a busy vehicular road of a village. The villagers of the area always were compassionate towards and protected the tallest flying bird of the world. The pair has constructed an island of about 2 meters diameter with water hyacinth and other herbaceous material available in the wetland. The female mostly lays 2 eggs with a gap of about 48 hours. The eggs hatch between 26 to 31 days. Both the male and female exchange their duties turn by turn to incubate the eggs and protect the nest. Pair keeps announcing to other inhabitants of their territory their supremacy time to time by their typical dancing postures. This is the displacement activity when the nest is threatened. Both the parents keep refurbishing the nest. The predators to the eggs are crows, dogs, jackals, etc. Whenever a slight threat is observed, the parent moves to the nest for protecting the eggs. A small arterial road leading to a village has another wetland created by the soil excavated for road construction. It is the habitat for many egrets, jacanas and cormorants. Another Sarus laid eggs and started planning next generation. All these wetlands are adjacent to the roads. Regular movement of humans and vehicles never disturb them. And in addition, the residents of the villages have provided them the additional protection they needed. Friends, Nature Revisited is coming up with more videos on nature and wildlife. Please click the like button if you like the content of this video. Give your comments and subscribe to the channel. Thus, days and weeks have passed and the hatching time was nearing. In the meantime, in a third wetland, which is situated between Lucknow Agra expressway and Karhal Mainpuri road, a pair of Sarus built nest and laid eggs. This wetland has representation of black-headed ibis, black-winged stilts, pond herons, egrets, and so on. Finally, one of the two eggs has hatched. The parent has become more careful and started taking full care of the newborn chick, and at the same time incubating the remaining egg. The parents started training the chick so that it can be moved to a safer destination from the predators. Friends, Nature Revisited is coming up with more videos on nature and wildlife. Please click the like button if you like the content of this video. Give your comments and subscribe to the channel. Finally, when it learned to walk, both the parents along with the chick moved to nearby grasses. The parents gave full protection to the juvenile and trained in collection of food and lead an independent life. When the juvenile has grown up, the parents drive away the juvenile at the age of about 2 years. The chick has grown into an adult and then they get separated from the parents and join the non-breeding individuals in a wetland nearby, where other birds like painted storks take shelter. Thank you. The non-breeding adults form into pairs and get separated from the non-breeding flock and establish their own territory, and thus the life cycle goes on.